that we know what mixed numbers are, let's try some mixed number arithmetic. Try some addition here, 3 and 1 ninth plus 5 and 2 sevenths. Now we know how to add fractions, so if we just turn these mixed numbers into fractions, we should be all set. We'll start with 3 and 1 ninth. 3 and 1 ninth is just 3 plus 1 ninth. And we can add these, make a single fraction by getting a common denominator. It's 27 over 9 is 3, plus 1 over 9, and that gives us 28 over 9. And now we'll do the same thing with 5 and 2 sevenths. 5 and 2 sevenths, that's 5 plus 2 sevenths. Get a common denominator of 7. 5 is just 35 over 7. And we add our 2 sevenths, and we get 37 over 7. So to add these two, we add these two fractions here. Well, that means we're going to have to get a common denominator. Common denominator is going to be 9 times 7, so we're going to have to multiply 28 by 7 and multiply 37 by 9. That sounds like a lot of work. Hey, wait a second. We don't have to add these. We can just add these. We didn't need to do all this. I mean, this is nice. We see how to turn a mixed number into a fraction, but we don't need that for this problem. So I'm going to go ahead and wipe that out. We don't need that at all because all we have to do is add these two numbers. 3 plus 1 ninth plus 5 plus 2 sevenths. We can add these four numbers, 3, 5, 1 ninth, and 2 sevenths, in any order we want to. We just add these up. We add the 3 and the 5. And we add the 1 ninth and the 2 sevenths. That's a lot easier to deal with. The 3 and the 5, of course, that's just 8. And again, we're going to find a common denominator here between 1 ninth and 2 sevenths. That common denominator is still 9 times 7. Multiply the top and bottom of the 1 ninth by 7. Multiplying 1 by 7 is a lot easier than multiplying the 28 by 7. That gives us 7 over 63. And then the 2 sevenths, we're going to multiply the top and bottom of that by 9. And that'll give us 18 over 63. And when we add these all up, we still have our 8. 7 63rds plus 18 63rds gives us 25 63rds. And notice that we write our final answer here as a mixed number. The problem is written in terms of mixed numbers. Final answer in terms of a mixed number. All right, let's try one more. Now that we know how to handle this, 12 and 2 thirds plus 9 and a half. And we know what we want to do here is break up each mixed number into its integer part and its fractional part. And we can add up the two integers, 12 plus 9, and then we add our two fractions, plus 2 thirds plus 1 half. 12 and 9, of course, is 21. And then the common denominator here is just going to be 6. 2 thirds is 4 sixths. 1 half is 3 sixths. So that gives us 21 plus 7 sixths. Now, I can't really write that as 21 and 7 sixths. We want the fractional part to be between 0 and 1. What I can do here is I can take that 7 sixths and write it as a mixed number. 7 sixths is just 1 and a sixth. Now we see how to add these up. 21 plus 1 and a sixth, well, that's just 22 and a sixth. And we're done.